Hello everyone, my name is Struan and I'm a scientist at Izon Science, and today I'll be walking you through how to set up a nanopore on your Exoid. First, check your Exoid is plugged in and connected to a computer, turn the power on, open the Exoid Control Suite software, and wait for the Exoid to connect. Click on the Investigation Details button and fill in the Investigation ID, Nanopore ID, and NP number. The Nanopore Setup button should now be available. Click on it and follow the prompts to load your nanopore. Load 75 microliters of wetting solution into the lower fluid cell, making sure that there are no bubbles. Attach the upper fluid cell, add 35 microliters of wetting solution to the upper fluid cell. Mount the shielding cap, insert the pressure nozzle, and close the lid, and then press start. Wait for the wetting process to complete. If the pore does not wet after 2 minutes, you may need to tap on the pressure nozzle firmly with the back of your pressure application device. Then remove the pressure nozzle. Wait for the device to move into the load position. Remove the wetting solution from the upper fluid cell. Remove the upper fluid cell. Remove the nanopore and dry it with a lint-free tissue or a nitrogen gun. Wipe all the residual liquid from the lower fluid cell. Reload the nanopore on the stretcher and click OK. Wait for the stretcher to move to the setup position. Load 75 microliters of your measurement electrolyte into the lower fluid cell. Check if there are any bubbles visible under the pore. If there are any bubbles, you'll be prompted to remove and clean the pore and then load electrolyte again. Attach the upper fluid cell. Add 35 microliters of measurement electrolyte. Attach the shielding cap. Insert the pressure nozzle and close the lid. The setup will now ask if you are measuring samples of a biological nature to determine if the coating sequence needs to be run. If you are not running this sample type, click No to move on. Otherwise, remove the pressure nozzle and the shielding cap. Remove the electrolyte from the upper fluid cell. Remove the upper fluid cell. Then remove the electrolyte from the lower fluid cell. Load 75 microliters of Izon coating solution into the lower fluid cell. Checking that there are no bubbles. Then attach the upper fluid cell. Add 35 microliters of coating solution. Mount the shielding cap, insert the pressure nozzle, and close the lid. Wait for the coating process to complete. This will take approximately 10 minutes at the maximum pressure of 2,500 pascals, which we have sped up for the purposes of this demonstration. Remove the pressure nozzle and the shielding cap. Remove the coating solution from the upper fluid cell. Remove the upper fluid cell. Remove the nanopore. Rinse with deionized water. And dry with a lint-free tissue or a nitrogen gun. Remove all the residual liquid from the lower fluid cell. Rinse the lower fluid cell with DI water. And dry with a lint-free tissue. Reload the nanopore on the stretcher. Load 75 microliters of your measurement electrolyte into the lower fluid cell. Check if there are any bubbles visible under the pore. Attach the upper fluid cell. Load 35 microliters of measurement electrolyte into the upper fluid cell. attach the shielding cap and insert the pressure nozzle and close the lid. Wait for the initial characterization process to complete. This involves the system measuring the baseline at multiple stretches at 1000 pascals, adjusting the voltage to result in a current of approximately 100 nanoamps. The nanopore will then be characterized using calibration particles to complete this process. To do this, replace the measurement electrolyte in the upper fluid cell with 35 microliters of calibration particles. The calibration particles you use will depend on the size of the pore you're using. For this instance, we'll use CPC 200s. Insert the pressure nozzle, close the lid, and press start. Wait for 100 blockades to be measured. The software will then display the particle size range of this nanopore. This is the full range that the pore can measure across different stretches from 45 millimeters to 49 millimeters. Click Done to finish the nanopore setup process. The Exoid is now ready to perform sample analysis. If you have completed the nanopore setup, a slider to choose your target size range for analysis will be available when you have chosen which analysis you would like to complete and entered your sample details. Please contact us at support@izon.com for more information or if you have any questions.